What is up, everybody? Opie0909 back here with another video. I'm again joined by Rockers Reviews Frank and Big Roy Money 55. Roy, what we're doing today in this vlog here is show and tell. We picked three items, could be anything. It's not just strictly movie related, could be anything.
Not that kind of show and tell.
Nah. Okay. Yeah. Listen, if that's one of your picks, you got three of them, so go ahead. Yeah, so that's what we're doing here, show and tell. And actually, before I get started, I actually want to ask you guys what you guys think. I think we're going to do it anyway. But in regards to content, I haven't been putting up a ton of content. I kind of get in the mood to make a video, in the mood to not make a video, or out of the mood to make a video. I think Frank and Roy had talked to me about maybe wanting to make videos of their own, and we'll throw them on the channel and just make it. I'll probably keep the Opie name, but...
And just expand the
channel.
Exactly.
Put more content on there. And like I said, you guys seem to enjoy the three of us, you know, and I'm all for them, you know, putting content up and helping the channel grow.
Different things going on.
Also, real quick, congrats to the channel, I guess. Thank you guys. We're over 400 subscribers. That's fantastic. I'm not even a year yet, and we're at 400 subs.
Wow.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it for watching.
Guys, have anything to say before we start officially?
That is 357 more than I thought we would get.
That's awesome.
No, agree with Jar. You know, tell us if you want. It's starting to get warm out. We want to do filming locations, stupid shit, crazy stuff, weird stuff, strange stuff in the city.
Plus, Roy's got a drone, so he takes like killer videos.
We can
so
get anywhere.
Maybe
nobody
incorporate
can stop
some
us.
Of that in there. It'd be pretty sweet.
So yeah, we're thinking we're gonna expand the content.
Expand the channel, yeah.
Opie is still gonna make his Opie videos. He's still gonna be Opie, but we're just gonna
spice it up. Let's get two other guys' takes. You know, on videos and blogging and everything.
Put a little more something in there.
Yeah. All right, so anything else, Frank, before?
Really
you
appreciate
want to do
everybody
normal?
Watches.
Bing, bang, boom.
Let's kick it off. Frank, right. Me.
Frank, you get started.
Jared, finish.
Okay. I have stuff in the beginning here. I had this app, and I had it for a while. It's a journal app. And if anybody likes writing or, like, just keeping a journal for everyday bullshit or just something to jot something down, look back on. I recommend this app right here. Fuck, you can't really say it. If you could say it, it would say day one.
It does say that.
Day one.
Day one. That's the name of the journal. I think it costs a couple bucks, but it's great. It's one of the best journal apps out there. I love it. I use it all the time. And then when me and my wife found out we were pregnant, of course.
Is this another announcement? You're going to announce to the YouTube community finally that...
I'm a father.
Yeah, last time you told me that it was a big thing. You said you had to take a shit.
There was a big thing that day.
You up
but
for...
I know, and I fucked it up because I was taken off guard. Anyway.
So you didn't see Logan that day?
I did not see Logan that day. I went to go see it by myself, like Steven fucking Glansberg, in the movie theaters by myself.
Sorry about
I laughed. I cried. People were right next to me. I don't know
That's
them. Right. I was holding hands.
That's right,
yeah. Back on topic. So, as soon as me and my wife found out that we were pregnant, of course, I put it, you know, I made a journal entry about how I felt, what was going on, I took pictures, shit like that. Then, it dawned on me that I would like to do something for my daughter and my wife, you know, while my daughter, later on in life, she'll be able to look back and see what it was like, you know, for us to be pregnant with her and everything that we went through. So, I kept the journal entry, and... All throughout the pregnancy, I would go in like every like couple times a week, and I would just give updates. I would give doctor's appointments, like the names. Me and my wife were tossing around the namer, like who chose the colors in the room in the nursery, and like the decision, like the theme to put it all up there.
I did. No, I didn't.
And like the highs and lows, the emotions, what I expected from the pregnancy, and like the thoughts and all of having, you know, a child, and like my emotions throughout the entire thing, and you know, food cravings for my wife, and just everything. If you can think of it, I wrote it all down. Then I went online. I got the PDFs or PFDs. I forget what it's called. PDF. You're able to transfer that from the app to Blurb. It's called blurb.com. And with a little tweaking and another app, you're able to make this book right here.
How much is the Canadian price
right there? This book goes for $37. You can get it at your local bookstores.
Wow.
Barnes & Noble's, Borders.
Cal Door.
Borders? Are they reopened?
Oh, wow. Yep, everything.
Watch out, right there, brother.
But it's a legit book. I am super impressed with it. I did not know it was going to come out this great. Yeah, as you see, you can just, like, go through, and I got, like, pictures and all kind of, like, really, really cool stuff going on in there. I don't know if you can see, but, you know, a lot of writing. It's a legit book.
Personally, and it is, I mean, it's awesome. It has time, locations, yep. When he's writing. I mean, I wonder what my book would look like.
it would probably be 3 pages long.
Probably.
But, so, when my daughter's older, I want her to be able to read this, and she'll have to wait until she's old enough to read it.
I'll show my 3 pics off.
Because I was no hold to bar. This is raw, real, emotional, a lot
raw?
Of...
Raw? Huh?
Christ, I'm talking about a fucking...
Okay, all right, you're right. I'm sorry, I'm very...
Jesus, it's all this alcohol. Whenever you drink, this is what happens. Your mind goes into...
It's like a demon inside trying to bust out. But, wait, speaking of, Jared, what would your book
anyway,
detail?
It's fucking great.
Your baby book for your children.
I don't know, but Frank's coming with that, because that's like eight of them, I'm about right? to tear up over here. That's awesome. I don't even know that exists.
Oh, yeah, here. You can, here.
I need to look through it, but yeah. Here, I brought some crappy show-and-tell items, and he brought this one.
Now, actually, my one item is going to top Frank's.
I don't know, man.
It's more important.
Anyway, but I wanted her to have something to look back on, and it's pretty, there's a lot of, like, F-bombs and, you know, shits and fucks going on throughout that book, so she'll have to wait till she's
I can't believe the sex pictures in the back, too. That's kind of...
You are fucking something else, ain't you?
I'm kidding.
Yeah, I got a couple pictures of your mother in there, too.
Ah, well, that's a different book. Hey, but I'm in there a couple times. Jared, did you make the book?
You're getting cut out real quick.
Probably no mention of the vlog.
Anyway, let's move on here. I would like to consider that I have a decent movie collection. And my very first DVD that I bought it at Blockbuster Video on Aramingo Avenue.
Yep, rest in peace.
I went in there.
Rest in peace.
It's been gone for a while now. I went in there and they had this movie for rent. I think it was like $5 or some shit like that. As soon as when DVDs first came out, I think it was rent for $5. But for an extra $10 or $15, I think it was on sale. I forget. It was back in 99. You could buy it on DVD. And I had a DVD player. I wasn't going to start buying DVDs, but I said, fuck it. And I bought
this.
Here
it is. Look at this.
Stigmata.
Look at this.
There you have it. Patricia Arquette.
Remember DVDs were like $25 to $30 almost?
Remember VHS tapes were like $90?
Yeah.
That was weird. Wasn't that weird?
Weird time.
Stigmata. This is not a good movie. Do not go out, get this movie. Like, if you've seen it, you know, I'm talking about it. I didn't really like it, but first DVD, so it has a special place in my heart, and that's my number 2.
Yeah.
Okay, I don't even remember half the shit that happened in the movie, to tell you the truth, because it's not that memorable.
She took a fall.
I don't care.
She got some scars on her hands.
That's great. Okay. The third one. My first book that I ever read. Now. We all read books in high school because we had to read books in high school for English class or whatever else. But you always fucking, you skip through, you get just enough material to write the book report. And then you move on. Well, I read this, I got it by myself, and this is the first book that I read on my own that I wanted to read, not as a project or anything. And I forget how old it was, I think it was like 15 or 16. But, Long Walk. My fingers are in the way. Stephen King. It's a really good book. It's also about teenagers and a couple kids. They go on this, they walk for days, and if they slow down, if they stop, they got 3 chances. If they stop more than like a couple seconds, they get killed. But the last one standing gets whatever they want in the entire world, like anything they want. And I was able to relate to it only because I was like same age group, stuff like that. But, Long Walk, you like King, he does no wrong, so, if you like him, go check out this book. Big fan.
They're some pretty cool items.
Yeah, thank man, there's no thank way you. On top of that, I'm kind of...
Absolutely.
Maybe we can stop the vlog, I'll go home for a second and get some...
Okay, yeah, that's
maybe
fine.
Maybe I'll find some heart in that.
Mine's all done.
Who's going?
I'm right, going.
Corey, I got
you
a question,
go? I'm
going
to go. I was,
you
want to
go?
I thought we were going to do
okay,
original
go ahead,
setup.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Yeah, did you bring your mother's dildo for the show and tell?
Save the worst for
it's
last.
It's charging. It's charging. But I will say this. Do you remember, as a young chap, it was like when you would rent a movie, they would be like, if you don't bring it back, it's like $80. Anybody remember this?
Cool. You have to buy it?
Or, so, quick story real quick.
I remember you would have to buy it.
It would charge you like the max.
Monster Squad. Me and my buddy Al used to flip-flop, basically. There was only one copy in the video store, West Coast Video. And if you lost that VHS, or if you wanted to buy it off them, $75.
Yeah.
$75 for a VHS, $75.
I remember when The Faculty came out on VHS, I was like, you know what? I love this movie. I want to buy it. So I went to the counter or whatever. I was like, I want to buy this movie. Where can I buy this movie at? $90.
I remember like the wrestling VHS. I think they were like hundreds of them.
Yeah.
Like 120 or something, I remember.
Yeah. I guess because they didn't have a lot of copies. Yeah.
You know what I did though? Yeah. I hooked up two VHS players and I popped it in, pushed player on one, record on the other.
Better watch out that FBI in the beginning of the VHS ain't watching this.
I think
this.
There's like a statute of limitations. I did this back in like whenever I did it.
All right, here we go. Anyway. I'm gonna show my stuff off. Are you done?
I fucking can have you how's your show cup, something, please?
How's your cup of coffee? Good.
It's good.
So, as you guys see, maybe, I'm a big kid. I love toys. Todd McFarlane came out when we were, I guess, in grade school, like sixth grade, and that was the toys to get. Todd McFarlane. Spawn, the Movie Maniacs line, Realistic Detail. This figure. My dad took me to New Jersey to get this. It's the Todd McFarlane release of Babe Ruth. Now, Babe Ruth, every kid, you love baseball. This is the guy that they have all the stories, all the myths, all the, you know, I don't know. Like, some of them are stories that are like fairy tales, but I was really excited to get this figure. It means a lot to me. Never opened it, and as a kid, that is like such an accomplishment because you've really got to try hard not to play with this thing, but still have it.
Can you play with it, or is it just like stuck in one position?
Sure, you can play with it. I think his arms are moved. Eh, I don't know.
Oh. Open it.
I think a lot of Doug McFarlane, all his statues are statues. They don't.
Yeah. Well, his arms are moving. And what I did, though, there was a McFarlane Jaws release for Movie Maniacs, and it's the orca, and he's eating Quint. And I was in Sunco's Video, had it in my hands.
What was it? $500?
No, it was $40.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yeah, this is when came out. I settled, put it down, and opted for something else. It's kind of embarrassing, the Kiss Psycho Circus release. And now I'm trying to get it, and it's like $350 on eBay. So that's one for me. Don't beat fucking Frank's lifeblood, but whatever.
Yeah, no, we're just going downhill from here.
This is important, though. This is Jared's guy.
Oh, man.
Creature of the Black Lagoon poster signed by Ben Chapman, who plays the creature on land. But he signed it. Aloha, welcome to my Black Lagoon, Ben Chapman. My aunt actually gave this to me. She gave me like 12 of these, you know, these Universal movie posters. I kept them in good shape through the years, and they are proudly displayed downstairs in my living room. But this one means the most to me because this is the only one I had a shot to actually get autographed because the rest of them are all passed away. And recently in 2008, Ben Chapman also passed away, so I'm going to hold on to this one. This is very special to me with my love for Universal Monsters. And last but not least, if you look on eBay for this item, it's going to cost you about $1,000, believe it or not. But if you have Amazon Prime, you can stream it for free. Jar?
What?
What is it?
I'm not telling what it is. I know what it is, and I'm super jealous, but
I'm not that jealous.
I'm super jealous.
This big guy right here. The Unsolved Mysteries Ultimate Collection Chest. These were given to me for Christmas many moons ago, but if you open this up, I don't know if you can see this. Oh, by the way, tell us if you like our new lighting situation. This is Frank's idea, FJC Photography's idea. We brought in a professional here.
It's a little dark, but there was.
You can't see my DVDs. You can't see Jer's face.
It's dim. That's because I'm wearing a hat. It's too dark. It's too light. Sorry. It's a bad room for lighting.
Jer looks like Resurrection Mary. But all right, stop. So it's split up to UFOs, ghosts, psychics, strange legends, murders, bizarre murders. And they give you a bonus disc. It's Treasures and Ghosts. But
I have a question.
Oh, come on, here we go. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Were any of these mysteries solved since the release of the DVD?
Yeah.
I'm sure some of
really?
Them.
Well, yeah. These are, like, when they released these, they put the updates in there after the original episodes. But even the ones on Amazon Prime. And then they also made another series with Dennis Ferrer.
I remember that one, yeah.
And they would update them.
But they would keep the original stars.
Yeah.
Not really. That's a big-ass
mustache. But these, when I was a kid, used to watch them all the time. Me and my mom creeped me the fuck out, some of them. And actually scratched off a major bucket list. We recently went to Chicago. I was able to go to Resurrection Cemetery, which is my favorite episode of Unsolved Mysteries, Resurrection Mary. If you didn't watch it, it's hard to find these on YouTube, too, because the rights purpose.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But try to check out that legend. It's actually pretty interesting. And Chicago does consider it an actual ghost of, based on all the accounts and sightings. Mm-hmm. We didn't see her, though. And we couldn't even find her grave because it was unmarked, but we tried our best. Failed.
Made for effort.
But that's my three things that mean, I don't know. I just wanted to show off and show you guys, you know, some stuff.
Oh, man.
Man, Jerry, you're really into my list here.
There's all this stuff that's heartfelt. I got...
Jerry, do we have time for you?
I don't know, because I want to keep it under 20. We're 16 something already. Well, no. I'll be quick.
All right, let's wrap it up.
We start with an 8 minute spot, Jerry.
All right.
That's all 8 minutes.
Okay. I'm going to be quick here. Again, none of my stuff. I got to go back to the drawing board, because my stuff isn't nearly as good as the stuff they brought. But anyway, we're going to run through it pretty quick. First here, if anybody knows me, they know Ryan Gosling's my favorite actor. They know Drive's my favorite movie. And something that meant a lot to me, means a lot to me.
Ryan Gosling's used condom.
My official replica Drive jacket here.
Wow.
From, what do we got there? From Steady Clothing. It's a 2X because I'm a bigger guy. Biggest size they had. Doesn't fit me too well now. I put a couple extra pounds on, but straight inside there. It's pretty fancy. Racing nice jacket.
Mm-hmm.
I actually wore this to the bottle bar, which you guys are familiar with. They had a showing of Drive, and I was the cool guy that wore this jacket.
Did you get any compliments?
I did. People were like, oh, wow, that's the jacket from the movie.
They're like, oh, my God, that's Ryan Gosling.
I think it's pretty freaking sweet, though. A little pricey, but worth it.
How much, Jer? No, I'm kidding. Don't say.
Yeah, because Julie will watch a video and get my ass torn up. All right, second here, I'm going to switch it up. And I'm going to go, everybody knows, again, if you know me and you watch my videos, you know I'm a huge wrestling fan. So this here is Mr. Perfect. This is the only carded figure I have from the Hasbro line. The Hasbro line is my favorite wrestling figure collection. This also is not the American release because the American release Hasbro is about 200 or more. I actually saw somebody trying to sell it for $500 the other day. This is the Italian version, which I got for $25 from a local collectible store. So Hasbro's, again, my favorite collection. A lot of stores with me and picking these up. I remember going and seeing these at, you know, Toys R Us and KB Toys on the pegs.
Kitty City, Jerry. Remember Kitty City?
Kitty City. Oh, Kitty City, yeah. Going, my grandpa and my mom is just going. And these things were cheap as hell, so you'd go and pick a couple up. But the first one I actually had was a Hulk Hogan from Series 1. But, again, I wanted to bring a carded figure just to kind of show you. And, again, it's not a Hasbro. It's this GG company in Italy. But most of the writing's in English and all. So, again, my love for wrestling, nostalgia for me here. Again, if you watch my videos, you know I've been trying to collect all the Hasbros again. They just mean a lot to me. Like, again, the stories, especially going with my grandpa, picking these things up. So, there's Mr. Perfect there. I hope to one day get the American card, but...
That's not worth it. I mean, it's the same thing.
And the third thing here, and this was given to me by one of my favorite guys on here on YouTube, Ryan, Blu-ray Lantern. Guy's an amazing artist. He made me this, and he also made me an ornament, a Jason ornament for my tree. He gave me this past Christmas. Awesome guy. I'm going to put his link down there. Check him out. Subscribe to him if you haven't. I think he just hit 500 subscribers,
wow,
which is awesome. But one of the great, like the most genuine, nice guys on here. I talk back and forth with him. I don't have a bad word to say about that guy. He's an awesome guy. Check his channel out. But he actually painted me.
This is impressive.
This Ryan Gosling little, I don't know, poster. What is this?
Poster.
Well, it's
canvas.
Canvas. Yeah, canvas. Yeah. So he painted this. Hand painted. We even got, you know, got the signature on the side there. But I was so impressed and so happy with this. You know, I didn't expect it. But he told me, listen, I've been drawing something, and I think you'll like it. I'm going to send it your way. And I'm like, you don't have to, man. But, you know, if you do, I'd appreciate it. And this showed up at my door in this big box. I think he paid like $30 for shipping, too, which is crazy. But that this just means so much to me. Again, getting it from a fellow YouTuber and a guy I've become friendly with, And the fact that this isn't, there's one of one. This is the only one that's made, and he made this his own hands, and he drew this specifically for me, knowing my love for the movie and just being a, you know, him just being a great guy. So that is my third item there. So again, thank you, Ryan. I appreciate that, man. This thing's awesome. Whew. So that is that. We have any last closing question. Words?
Jerry, you want to start it off? You have anything to say?
Yeah, again.
No. Well, besides, again, tell us what you think of, you know, Frank and Roy throwing some content on here, you know, getting more out there. Again, thank you for all the subscribers that subscribe to my channel. I apologize. I go in and out of moods with YouTube. All of a sudden, I haven't been doing it for a year, but like I watch videos and sometimes I don't feel like watching videos and commenting and all, but I've been trying to go through everybody's videos I missed. So be on the lookout. You know, I'll be commenting on your videos and all. You guys support me. I want to support you back. I just feel that's fair. And I like a lot of you guys on here. You guys are all great. So,
yeah, we've been trying to get out there too. Frank and I, to, you know, talking to everybody. This is all new to us. Jerry's the crafty veteran.
Yeah.
Yep.
Frank, you got anything?
I just want to say I appreciate everybody for checking out, watching. Actually looking forward to putting up new content. Yeah, like Jar said.
I might do like an out and about or something. I still want to go under the L. I think going under the L in Philly would be fantastic just to see. It's just disgusting. Pretty good pawn shops under there.
It's getting warmer out. I'm just going to be able to, you know, be in the north, do some out and about stuff.
Yeah.
Maybe pack some backpacks with beer, go under the L, try there to find go. Some cool stuff.
Hookers and druggies. I'll film everything so you guys will see it.
Yeah, so, you know,
nitty gritty.
You know, look out. This channel is really, you know, 400 subs. Thanks. You know, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Congrats, Jared.
Yes.
That's thanks to these guys. Like I said, all the people that have shouted me out over the past, not even year, but I have all, you know, most of you guys to thank. And for everybody for sticking with me, I know I go back and forth again with putting content up, but the fact that you guys have stayed and continue to comment on my videos and like my videos, I always get that one dislike.
I know. Who is
from
that?
Somebody. But it doesn't matter because, again,
you motherfucker. You hear me?
At the end of the day, it's activity on the channel. So, and again, not everyone will like your content. So
I know.
I appreciate the fact that he still gave me a dislike.
Or a view.
He cared enough.
At least a
view. He cared enough to give me a view, and it could be a she. It might be my own wife. Who knows? Oh, but, yeah,
hey,
so again,
for everybody.
Thank you guys so much.
And a real quick plug, Jar.
Go ahead, you gotta throw it in there.
My guy Colin, Heinous. He does crazy designs of the old Philadelphia Philly logo. Awesome t-shirts, awesome stickers he does. Check him out.
We'll throw his Instagram down in the bottom of the video as well. Check him out.
But you gotta check him out. And
I think that's it.
John.
Yeah, and check out our Instagrams if you haven't already. We got a bunch of different content on there. We got books, we got comics, we got Disney World.
Mm-hmm.
And
then you have my adventures on my personal account.
Yep.
So we'll throw them all down there. All right. So that is the end of the vlog.
Bye bye, guys.
Take care. See Thanks, you. Everybody that watches. Comment below. Let us know what you think. It'd be cool if you guys list, you maybe your three. I mean, you know, show them, but tell us your three items.
Communicate with us, we'll talk.
Yeah.
Text.
We like to, you know, going back and forth with you guys. I love when everybody comments and all. So, take care.
Get the comments.
We'll see you in the next vlog. Auf Wiedersehen.
Bye-bye.